My teachers chose me because of the area where we lived. And they happened to know that in somewhere in this back corner, there was a settlement of the ancient Tequesta. And the legend was around here was the Fountain of Youth. Take this out and we can study what contaminants are in that water.
It looks like a jellyfish.
But it's not a jellyfish, okay? Okay, so, it's gonna turn into a jellyfish. Oh no.
Oh god, a jellyfish.
And then you see the color of that water? And you see this one? You see that one? That's what water is supposed to look like. This is the way it's supposed to look like it. See? How pretty?
That's real water.
That's real water. Much of Mama's heart for me. The fear for them is because they already experienced war, understand? Ready to drop nuclear bombs in the United States, especially Florida. So they were concerned about the water source and Quinny. Quinny was the factor. Quinny was a Comanche Seminole. And she was about 5'8". The meanest woman, but the most kind woman you ever imagined. She was born in Oklahoma when they gathered all the natives and they took them up there, okay? And she was in charge of keeping the Brickell daughters company. She heard the story and then she came to Miami. She says, Miami, Ishmael is here, but you just gotta work and look for it. The story, she picked it up when she was a young girl. I told her, I'm looking for the Fountain of Youth. And then she goes, dig! And you'll find it. So I started excavating, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 years old, 17 and 18, a little bit crazy because of Vietnam. You know, I became like a wild hippie character. And they thought I was not gonna go finish the project, but I committed myself verbally and I continued digging. And I started exposing more deformation. And sure enough, there's the altar. This is the oldest altar in this part of the world, carving a prehistoric formation.